Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I would like to explain about epidemiology. In epidemiology, we will discuss about definition, objectives, aims of epidemiology, epidemiological trait, and levels of prevention. The word epidemiology is the combination of three Greek words, epi, demos, and logos. Epi means among, demos means people, and logos means study of science. So, epidemiology is the study of the distribution and determinants of health-related status or events in specified populations and the application of this study to the prevention and control of health problems. Next comes to the objectives. First is to describe the distribution and the magnitude of health and disease problems in human population. Second is to identify etiological factors in the pathogenesis of disease. Third is to provide the data essential for the planning, implementation, and evaluation of services for the prevention, control, and treatment of disease and to the setting up of priorities among those services. Next comes to the aims of epidemiology. The aims of epidemiology are described as: first is to determine the frequency and distribution of a disease in a population. Second is to identify the etiological to achieve control over the disease. Third is to develop plan and monitor health care policy for the disease control programs. Next is to describe disease patterns in human population. And last is to assess the economic effects of a disease and to analyze the cost and economic benefits of alternative control programs. Next comes to the epidemiological trait. For the occurrence of a disease in man, three things are required: agent, environment, and host. These three factors are referred to as epidemiological trait. Agent, one of the first requirement for the occurrence of disease. The disease agent may be living or non-living. The disease agents have been classified into five broad groups. First is biological agent. Biological agent means the living agents, example viruses, bacteria, fungi, protozoa. Second is nutrient agent. Nutrient agent means protein, fats, carbohydrates, vitamins, minerals. Physiological agents. Physiological agent means heat, cold, pressure, radiation, electricity, etc. Chemical agent. This may be metals, forms, gases, etc. Mechanical agent. Mechanical agent means chronic friction and other mechanical forces may cause trauma, injuries, and fractures. Next comes to the environmental factors. A healthy environment is crucial for the health and well-being of individuals and communities. It is divided into three components: physical environment, biological environment, and social environment. Last factors is host factors. The host related factors are age. Second is sex. Third is heredity. Fourth is nutrition, occupation, customs and habits, and last is human behavior. Next comes to the levels of prevention. First is primordial prevention. Prevention of chronic disease, prevention of the emergence or development of risk factors in countries or populations groups in which they have not yet appeared. Second is primary prevention. It is defined as action taken prior to the onset of disease, which removes the possibility that a disease will even occur. It signifies interventions in the pre-pathogenesis phase of disease or health problems. Modes of intervention in primary prevention are health promotion and specific protection. First is health promotion. Health promotion is the process of enabling people to control over and to improve health. Second is specific protection. The currently available interventions are immunization, use of specific nutrients, chemoprophylaxis, protection against occupational hazards, protection against accidents and avoidance of allergies. Third is secondary prevention. It can be defined as the action which helps the progress of a disease at its incipient stage and prevention complications. Fourth is territory prevention. When the disease process has advanced beyond its early stages, it is still possible to accompany prevention by what might be called territory prevention. It includes disability limitation and rehabilitation. Disability limitation means when a patient reports late in the pathogenesis phase, then it is called disability limitation. Rehabilitation is a process used to give a healing touch to the patient who are suffering from physical and mental disorders or addiction.